Real Madrid are surprisingly difficult to use on FIFA 20, especially when compared to teams such as Paris Saint-Germain and Juventus. However, with some tactical fine-tuning and a bit of a reshuffle, it's possible to elevate Los Blancos so they rank among the most devastating sides in the game. There's certainly a sense that Ronaldo hasn't been replaced when it comes to using Madrid on FIFA. Nobody else combines his power, pace and all-round quality, but fear not. A combination of Eden Hazard, Karim Benzema and Gareth Bale can save the day. Switch the formation to 4-3-3 attack, bringing Hazard out from the wing and into attacking midfield behind Benzema. Place Vinicius Jr. on the left wing, with Bale on the right, and then partner midfield linchpin Casemiro with Luka Modric in the middle. Ferland Mendy is faster and more defensively minded than Marcelo at left back, so opt for him. Marcelo has the highest overall rating, but Mendy's increased work rate means he's better for this formation. The rest of the defence picks itself. Keep a balanced defensive style with this side. Madrid's default defensive width of 5 bars is right, but lower depth to 6. Although the defence is by no means slow, you're inviting too many through balls if you play much higher. Use a possession-based offensive style, making sure offensive width is set to 5 bars. Lower the amount of players getting into the box to 6, and keep set pieces on 3 bars each. This is a really solid base that can now be influenced further with player instructions that will let individuals shine. It's important to keep Benzema planted down the middle. Apply Stay Central and Target Man to his settings, the latter of which will force him to back into defenders when finding space to receive the ball. This will also stop him from dropping too deep. Put Hazard on stay forward and stick to position. You don't want to waste any of his energy defending as he is the main star of this team and the player who should impact things most often. These instructions will keep him close to Benzema and see him run beyond his teammate when attacks build. Vinicius Jr.'s supporting runs should be switched to get in behind. Your opponent will now have to consider the Brazilian's 93 rated pace at all times. A threat that's made even more menacing when you consider his 4-star weak foot and 5-star skill moves. Bale should be used quite differently on the right. Most opponents will know that you want to shift the ball onto his left foot, so it's vital to mix things up with him. It's surprisingly effective to put him on free roam, as most teams will expect you to simply cut inside instead. Bale doesn't have the worst weak foot in the game at 3 stars, but it's definitely better to avoid using his right where possible. Free roam will make his pattern hard to judge. He'll come short, he'll burst forward, and he'll take up smart positions to recycle the ball. Casemiro should have stay back while attacking applied. Leave Modric on default settings to his left. Yes, he's attack-minded, but with Hazard getting forward, it's worth allowing Modric to step up, especially as Casemiro and the defence are strong enough to impose without the Croatian being there. Both fullbacks should have stay back while attacking applied, but don't be afraid to manually trigger their runs after passing the ball. This is particularly useful on Dani Carvajal's side, as he can fill the space that Bale leaves open. This setup is best utilised with a smart, possession-based game. Adding Vinicius down the wing and Hazard through the middle naturally gives Madrid more pop across the front line. Keep the ball moving quickly, but be prepared to ping passes around the midfield until space opens up for an attack. Hazard and Benzema should also be seen as a striker partnership, with Bale being a constant nuisance due to the unpredictability of his role on the right. Don't be surprised if he sometimes forms a midfield three alongside Modric and Casemiro. If the opponent gets a grip on Bale, mix it up with a more traditional winger like Marco Asensio or Rodrigo. If Hazard gets snuffed out in the middle, consider pushing him wide and bringing Isco on to fill the CAM slot. Madrid have a wealth of options to bring off the bench. Forgotten man James Rodriguez is useful as an impact sub, and Luka Jovic can provide extra thrust when Benzema begins to tire. If you're trying to protect a lead and want a little bit more control in the middle, Kroos is the perfect replacement for Modric. This Madrid lineup features a bit of everything. It has speed, strength, and finishing ability. It can also possess one of the strongest benches you could wish for, meaning a strength in depth can have a significant impact as matches progress.